Hey there, welcome to Shape It Up. I am your host, Nicole Simonin, and I help women over 40 lose weight for the last time. Today's episode we're talking about is Thanksgiving weight gain permanent. So there are three places that you could be right now with your physique. So one, you're either maintaining your weight, or two, you've been steadily losing weight, or three, you're overweight and you're not losing any weight. So if you overeat on Thanksgiving, the first two, maintaining your weight and losing weight steadily, you don't really have to worry too much about if you're just overeating on Thanksgiving. It's not going to affect your physique too much. And if you've been losing weight, it's actually going to probably be a good thing if you are going up to a maintenance calorie level on Thanksgiving. But if you're in the last group, the overweight and not losing any weight, then yes, the Thanksgiving weight you're going to gain is going to be permanent. So let's put it in a financial framework. It's like accruing $20,000 of debt and then adding an additional $5,000 to your debt. So if you're in a deficit of $20,000 right now, and Thanksgiving Day is the $5,000, you are now in a 25K debt. Now, if you don't want to be in debt, and in our case, you don't want to be overweight, you're going to have a longer time paying off those extra calories that your body is storing. Now, the weight itself is really not the issue. It's how you think about yourself after overeating. You might be thinking, I ate too much food. Why do I keep doing this to myself? I'll never lose weight. I have no control when it comes to food. What's wrong with me? Why can't I lose the weight? This right here is where the permanent damage comes in. When you gain weight, what do you tell yourself? That you're a failure. You're a horrible human being that can't do anything right. You're shaking your head, yes. I hear you. I've been there too. But what if I told you that weight gain was neutral? So whether you gain, lose, or maintain your weight is 100% neutral. I'll wait for that to marinate for a second because your brain's gonna be like, no, that's not true. I'm overweight. That's a problem. It's just not gonna believe what I just said. So whether you are gaining weight, losing weight, or maintaining your weight is 100% neutral. Now, how do I know this is true? Because I can talk to a woman who technically is, say, 50 pounds, 100 pounds over her ideal weight, and she could love being at that weight. I could also talk to a woman who is 120 pounds, and she could think she's overweight and be very unhappy. Your weight is neutral. It's what you make your weight mean. This is where the potential permanent damage comes in. I also know this because I've been there. As a former professional ballet dancer, you're required to look a certain way. When I would weigh in at 115 pounds, it was considered unacceptable and I needed to be lighter. Fast forward to no longer being in the dance world, at 115 pounds, I would still feel like I was huge and unacceptable. Having just said that, did you say to yourself something like, I would love to be 115 pounds, or why is she complaining about 115 pounds? This right here is why 115 pounds are neutral. We all have different decisions and thoughts about what that scale weight means. This is why 115 pounds is neutral. This is why 200 pounds is neutral. So pay attention to what your brain is telling you. After learning about how my brain works, and I continue to work on this daily, I am more patient and compassionate to myself if I do gain weight. The beauty of the mindset work that I do on myself and with my clients is that I know exactly how to lose the weight, and I can choose how I want my body to look. If it's not looking the way that I want it to look, there's something going on with me in the way that I'm thinking about myself. Same thing for my clients. It's the way they're thinking about themselves. And that is what I actually work on. I'm not adding an hour of cardio to my day. I'm not cutting my calories so that I'm miserable. And this is what I see women doing when they first start working with me. So I want you to notice what you think about your weight. It could be your current weight. What do you think about what you weigh? Do the thought work you need to do to get your mindset in the right frame of mind for losing weight. And if you need help putting all the pieces together, let's chat. Go to shapeitupfitness.com/chat, C-H-A-T at the end there. All right, have a wonderful day. Join me tomorrow as we continue on daily Thanksgiving strategies to help you jumpstart your weight loss. See you tomorrow.